Genocide cases in Myanmar is never end since the independence of this country in 1948, especially in the era of Nguyen administration, caused a million of Rohingya's people fled to neighborhood countries such as Bangladesh, Thailand, Malaysia, and Indonesia. So, our team has decided to focus on the issue of genocide in Myanmar. The period of genocide will be focused in January to June 2019. Special rapporteur on the situation of human rights in Myanmar, Lee Leung-hee, told the Human Rights Council that Myanmar authorities have not taken any steps to end the systematic violence and persecution of the Rohingya people. Lee said Myanmar remains a country that continues to commit serious violation of international law. Humanitarian access remains severely restricted, and all parties involved in this violence, including the Myanmar military called Tan Madaw and the Rakhine Army, are responsible for indiscriminate mass bombing, shooting, and laying of landmines in areas where civilians gather. Since January, the violence has displaced some 65,000 people in northern Rakhine and southern Kachin states. The parties to the conflict must put an end to hostilities, said Lee. The Rakhine people have suffered enough, in addition to reports of deliberate burning of up to 6 villages since the end of June. Mrs. Lee noted with concern that the government had shut down internet service for nearly 3 months in the area of Kyoto, Nimbia, Wonangyun, and Rau'u, where the conflict was most intense. On May 6, 7 Myanmar soldiers are convicted because of the murder of 10 Rohingyan men in Indian. It is stated in November 2018 that they accused of 10-year prison terms. Unfortunately, due because of the military who are fully controlled the law and governmental, the soldiers who are responsible for the killing of 10 people in the Indian village are free from the jail with the help of the military without knowing why. There is a case where 2 reporters who uncovered the killing of the people in the Indian village accused for obtaining state secrets. They spent more time in jail, 16 months to be exact, longer than the soldier who killed 10 people in the Indian village. There are lots of covering ups by the military because the news about it spread very fast, yet the soldier is free from the 10-year prison terms. With this news, we all know that the human rights in Myanmar is still not preserved with good. There are lots of abuses and violations of the human rights, and it's pretty hard to change because of the military keep ruling the law and the governmental. Myanmar through a few decades have a lot of human rights violation, whether it is executed in hard or soft kind of ways. Since the past few years, the most highlighted problem that occurred in the state of Myanmar is of course the genocide. There are many cases which is placed Myanmar, the state of focus in the context of human rights violations, and throughout that, a lot of reported cases has been reported by international media and authority of the Myanmar themselves. Most of it, of course, it is involved mainly in the small states of Rakhine that caused the problem of refugees fled to the neighboring countries, mainly in the Southeast Asia. In duration of January until June 2019, there are a list of cases involving human rights violations, and we talk about event happened specifically in the Rohingya village Butidong. This location is the one of the reported battlefield between the Burmese army and Arakan army, the largest insurgent group in Myanmar, and what happened in there has brought suffers to the villagers. On 23 April 2019, a Burmese gunship struck the Rohingya village in Butidong. The military subsequently planned internationally banned landmines along the Rakhine state to prevent Rohingya from escaping northwest to the Bangladesh. Burmese soldiers allegedly gunned down Rohingya civilians fleeing south. Clothes that still remained in the village were allegedly targeted by the several attacks. Some has described Rohingya has been trapped in the side zone. This is not the first time that such incident happened in this village, as another cases between 2nd until 9th of May 2019. Rohingya homes and shops were burned in Maundong, the Butidong township. The OCHR information suggests that the authorities have taken no steps to investigate these attacks. Throughout few years back, this village has been targeted by the Burmese army to chase them away by conducting torturous acts or to use them as the forced labor. In April the same year, the United Nations said that it was disturbed by the report of continuing attacks on civilians in that state. Cases that happened in Butidong and any other village in Rakhine State has shown that series of human rights violations and genocide has occurred any known throughout the world, but still nothing has been done so far except international pressure on the Myanmar's government and a series of negotiations in the United Nations. In conclusion, Myanmar must solve this problem of ethnic conflict in other way, not with genocide and armed conflict that violates the human rights and causing uproar in the eyes of the world and specifically in the Southeast Asia.